Hello? Okay, that was weird. So, yeah. Don't know what the hell happened. My audio program decided to basically shit itself. So I gotta set up the noise gate again here. I think it was about there. There we go. That's probably good. There. Yeah, okay. That's probably fine. That's fine. Now, game audio. Game audio. Let us get game audio going here. That might be too loud. Down a little bit there. There we go. Damn audio interfaces, man. When they shit the bed, they really shit the bed. Okay. And here. I'm invisible on Discord. Okay. Where did we leave off? We got the heart key. Now I'm getting audio glitches. The hell am I getting audio glitches? Weird. How will I bug you then? Hey, Spart. I'm hoping these audio glitches kind of fix themselves here. It's not filling me with confidence, though. I don't know what this doubling up thing is. It's gonna be a nightmare. Or not. It's a little concerning that that wasn't a nightmare. Are you sure this is a way to go? Sherry should be out here. Yeah, cool.
Sherry, I've been looking everywhere for you. I was so worried. We've got to go now, honey, okay? If we stay here, that monster will find us. Let's go.
No, I won't.
What's the matter? Don't you trust me?
No.
It's not that, Claire. It's because of my daddy. He's over there. I heard him call my name. Daddy must have been attacked by the monsters. I have to help him.
Wait, Sherry. Don't go alone. Sherry! Sherry!
Now we play Sherry, who is 1,000 times more useless than Ada for a multitude of reasons. One, she doesn't have a gun, she only has a healing thing. But more importantly, because she's a tiny kid, when she jumps over boxes, it takes forever. To be honest with you, I was actually expecting dogs here, so a little surprising to me that it was zombies. A doubling up sound. The fuck's doing it, but it's bugging me. So this is the exact same puzzle as it was with Ada. Takes forever pushing stuff because she's a dumb, weak kid. And this happens every time, that animation to get up on a box. We have to do it 2 more times. Oh no, we don't. I'm an idiot. That was a waste of time. Ignore me. Just put me on mute so I can stop lying directly to your ears. We do have to do it here, though. God, it's just so painfully long. So yeah, literally the exact same puzzle as Ada. Nets you the same reward and everything. But whatever. It's a video game. Definitely having trouble with these loading animations tonight. This is trying to open.
Claire! Are you there?
Sherry, are you okay? Did you find your dad?
Yes, I'm okay. But I couldn't find him. But I did find something else for you. Here!
Thanks, sweetie.
Hey, Junkie.
Why don't you come over here?
Welcome.
I want you to stay with me.
Claire! I can't reach the ventilation hole anymore. But don't worry, I'll find another way. I can take care of myself.
Nice, Spark.
Wait, Sherry, come back. Sherry! Sherry!
Now have access to the back of the parking lot.
Got it.
I'm getting out of here and heading to the sewer. Can you meet me there?
I'm on my way.
Man, there is something going on here. I'm gonna try resetting the game, I think. Okay, maybe we'll do so from a save point. I know there's a save point here, but... nah. There's definitely some funkiness going on here. This open? No, it doesn't look like it. I do like that you can get across the whole parking garage before the dogs even realize you're there. I think there's dogs in here. Yeah, there's a dog right there. And we need to go to the land of dogs. Bow Wow. Exactly. Little Bow Wow. Man, there is something wrong going on here. This is what we need. Pick it up. Pick it the fuck up. Thank you. Always junkie, always. This is actually making this unplayable. Oh my god, I'm gonna get hit because of that. Holy shit, I should have got hit because of that. This is probably directly due to the fact that my stupid sound thing crashed right at the beginning. I bet it's directly due to that. Which is irritating to say the least. Since there's nothing in this hallway, I'm gonna actually see. Can we get into this? We can. All right. I don't remember if you get the card here, like you do with Leon. It would make sense that you do. Oh, there's a liquor. Oh, there's two liquors. Uh-oh. I'm dead. Maybe? Yeah, that's really, really bad. Holy Christ, is that bad. The slowdown is actually, yeah, it's making this unplayable. Alright, technical difficulties, we'll be right back. Alright, Spart. Have a good night. Try this again. I'm gonna have to do that Sherry part again, but that, I don't really care. That was unreasonable.
Resident Evil
2. Please be okay this time. Like, please, for me. Oh, this already feels good. Yeah. That crash really effed everything up. I am gonna need that later, eventually. Where the hell can I pick it up? I should take it with me now, because we're getting rid of this. Yeah, alright. In all honesty, I would rather replay that 15 minutes with it playing fine than play another 2 minutes with the way it was. Price, that was so bad. still surprising to me that there's nothing in this hallway. But whatever. Club key. Okay. Okay, okay. Dogs? Or nothing? I think nothing. This time, knowing that the liquors are in that room will be super beneficial. Oh, right, there's a thing there. I just picked up the lighter from there. Not that it matters.
Sherry, I've been looking everywhere for you. I was so worried. We've got to go now, honey, okay? If we stay here, that monster will find us. Let's go.
No, I won't.
What's the matter? Don't you trust me?
No, Claire, no.
It's not that, Claire. It's because of my daddy. He's over there. I heard him call my name. Daddy must have been attacked by the monsters. I have to help him.
Wait, Sherry. Don't go alone. Sherry! Sherry!
Unreasonable kid. Why you never try to negotiate with terrorists? All things considered, this part isn't too bad to get through. Come on, kid. Jump down in the sewer like a good little girl. Good old box moving simulator. Never gets old. This is what moving giant boxes is like in real life. Sim true to life. 7 out of 10 would play again. We're done. So long. Especially when that happens. She can lose her grip. And do like a second leg swing. It's just wrong. The funniest thing is watching a speedrun of this game. And then like, if they get the second leg swing, they're just like, oh crap, because it like cuts a good half second or second or whatever. Because it's an RNG-based thing. I do believe anyway. I don't think there's something that triggers that. Just is a longer animation every now and then. For the hell of it. For the heck of it, I should say.
Claire! Are you there?
Sherry, Are you okay? Did you find your dad?
Yes, I'm okay. But I couldn't find him. But I did find something else for you. Here!
Thanks, sweetie. Now, why don't you come over here? I want you to stay with me.
Claire! I can't reach the ventilation hole anymore! But don't worry, I'll find another way.
That kid was smart at all. She would just find something to boost her up.
Wait, Sherry, come back! Sherry! Sherry!
No good, Claire. Kid's not gonna listen to you.
Do you read me, Claire? We now have access to the back of the parking lot.
Got it.
I'm getting out of here and heading to the sewer. Can you meet me there?
I'm on my way.
All right. This time it would be really swell to not get hit by that dog and to actually pick up the crank right away, but we'll see what happens, I suppose. Oh, instead we might just get hit by that dog. It's kind of scary. Came out of that sewer the wrong way. You know what? Get this over with. One, where's the other? I don't think I'll hit him. There we go. It's a little too bad that it took 3 shots instead of 2, but fine. The whole reason we're getting this key card is to get a bunch of ammo, so. Oh, and I think we left the submachine gun for Claire, too. Oh, crap. I don't think I'm gonna have room for it, because I'm pretty sure that takes up. Pretty sure that takes up 2 slots. Do we have to do anything in here? I think the map is still in here. Yeah, I think we need to power this on to get the card reader working. Yeah, we did have to do that. Okay. And this time for her, there is a herb in here, where there wasn't for Leon. That's some BS. Darn, I wish I had left both the side pack and the submachine gun. I think there's only the one now. I think we should take this. I don't think you can overload this grenade launcher. You can. That actually might change everything. That might change everything. Can't remember what the round limit is, but there are really no bowgun bolts in here. That's really the pity. Yeah, it does take up 2 slots. Hey, Homer. I'm trying to think of what other doors the club key opens. And what other doors the diamond key still opens. Because if possible, I'd like to just open them and get rid of the key. Pretty sure the club key opens this one up here. As we found out earlier. Yeah, cool. In here for her, though. Can't actually even take it. I'm trying to think if I found any bowgun bolts yet at all. I don't think I have. I feel like there's something in... It's 2236. Was. That's a shame. Okay, we'll have to come back for that. Without a doubt. Handgun ammo. Got enough handgun ammo that I can just start capping zombies, I think. I'm trying to think of where the hell we go now. Oh, I think the diamond key actually opens up thing over here. And we also, this is why we brought the lighter. Oh, crap. All right. Uh-oh, that's really, really bad. I mean, we didn't get the submachine gun. Not to use it, so I'm okay with that. What I'm not okay with. Fucking god. Go away, man. Could use some of this handgun ammo, actually. Update you about my life? Not really a whole lot to update, man. I moved. Hey, Necro. It goes okay, man. It goes okay. I'm really worried that I don't have health for this area. Because spoiler alert, stuff happens here. Please. Okay. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, cool. The move went okay. We're still unpacking and doing all that stuff. But... yeah, it went good. The unpacking for the most part is done. It's just kind of like getting shelving and finding things to put things on now. It does take a while. It's a drain on like every resource you have. It's a financial drain, it's a mental drain, physical drain. Moving is actually just the worst thing. And if I ever have to do it again, which I will obviously, but it'll be too soon, for sure. Oh god, that's really too bad. I hope we can get rid of this key here. On this door. Please. My god, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Because we need two slots open. taking the submachine gun kind of screwed me. Anyways, here's where things start to get interesting. I feel like I'm missing one of them already. Moving is such a deterrent. Yeah. I hate it. Fuck off with your bullshit. That's why. Because I knew I was going to take a hit there. That's why it scared the shit out of me that I was at caution. I'm gonna end up taking another hit pretty soon here, so I'm gonna have to heal. Alright, this... Use up some handgun ammo. I'm okay with this. Later, K-Head. Have a good night. Yes, I definitely agree. Aw, crap, I still need that jewel. First of all, that's going away. I don't need this for right now. Wait. I am the world's biggest moron. Oh my god, I'm an idiot. No. That's infuriating. I need to go back to the basement. Because I forgot the whole reason why you go there. I need to get the crank from the dog pound. The reason why it's infuriating is because I did it. Like, before I restarted because of the weird glitches I was getting. Oh my god, I'm dead. Maybe. Really? Not even worse for wear? You know what? Do some target practice here. What if evil were a resident in your home? That make you feel better about moving? I don't know. Maybe. I have to say, that is the reason why I like Resident Evil 1 so much, is because it's actually in a house. It's actually in a residence. Did I ever grab the ammo from this guy? Yes, I did. How did I come up with my name? I didn't. My parents named me Paul. They named me after the beetle that I don't like, or that I least like. But that's fine. He still wrote some good songs. Whoa, hello, officer. Where's the other one? I wasn't expecting that dude there. There's not another one? There's just one dude waiting there for me. Lame. It was in the name of a blog I wrote on. Okay, he's dead. Dead, Jim. He's dead. Did have to move out because of a biohazard, actually. Really? What happened? No, Junkie, you're cute. This kitty cat, like the new place, he loves it. He absolutely adores it. Alright, let's see if I get this right this time. So this goes out 1, 2, 3.5. Then it goes 8.5, not 7.5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That was a full. I might actually hit the thing now. Oh, it wasn't enough. Huh. Interesting. Does the girlfriend like the new place? Yeah, she's the one that actually chose it. Well, kind of. I found it on the internet, and I told her, like, do you want to go take a look at this place? Because I was working when, I was working that day that the open house was or whatever. So she was like, yeah, I'll go take a look. And I told her, like, because of the price and everything, that if it was even half as, like, nice as it looked for that price or whatever, as long as there was enough room for stuff, we should totally just get it. You should get, like, an application and we'll just, like, tell them we want it right away. She was like, yeah, okay. She looked at it, she loved it. Came back with the application, we filled it out. And then to ensure that we got it, I also sent him an email telling him a little bit more about us. Like the two of us. We get after. And then he met us 2 days later. Met us 2 days later to sign the lease agreement. Then we paid him the security deposit and all that sort of good stuff. Go down the fucking ladder. I'm gonna catch up here. I lived in a renovated factory where it turned out just under the floorboards was a thing. Oh man, what? That's insane. Kitty cat greater than girlfriend and you liking it. Yeah, no, I agree. You know how people always say happy wife, happy life? No, man. Happy cat, happy life. Need a new place tour. Yeah, when most of the boxes are cleaned up and gone, that's definitely something that I would like to do as well. Also, this limping is the worst. I think in the hallway going down to the thing, there's still two herbs, so being a danger is just the worst. That fucking liquor. I found out the other night that apparently a liquor swipe does like 22 damage. Cat is happy but starts peeing on the floor. I mean, the cat doesn't pee on the floors during the best of times when he's like pissed off. But he never does that when he's happy. The most he does is, and I don't even really blame him for this. I feel more bad about it than I get angry about it. But he, I can get these while I'm at it now. he will gorge himself and eat too much, and then he'll feel sick and puke. And you can tell that it's not like a hairball puke, because he pukes up like what looks like his food, like not digested, because he just eats so goddamn much. So it's gotten to the point where we just can't feed him a full bowl. He has to be fed smaller amounts. You send the owner nudes for more about you? No. Nothing like that. Also, this is gonna sound like asshole-ish probably or racist as fuck, but whatever. It's nice now because this landlord is the first landlord I've had that is just like a normal white dude. Like, I had one white landlord before, but he was like some guy that took shrapnel to the head or something. He wasn't all there. He like spoke super slow sound and like did dumb stuff. So, by racist as fuck, I'm not gonna like say completely racist shit like that, but shrapnel face. No, he had like a dent in his head or something. Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. Oh no. No more hits, no more hits. Okay, we're good. Cat is happy, starts peeing on the floor. God damn you, Homer. Why do you wish shit upon me? Why would you do that to me? Can't tell if these guys are racy yet, but I want to see. Okay, there is a thing here. We're gonna go for that. Okay. I don't know where this dog is, and it's not good. He's right there. God damn it. This game actually makes me just hate dogs. I crave a normal landlord. This landlord's kinda cool too. It's funny because, alright, there's a herb in here. I should get that. Because, when I was setting up my office or whatever, he came in to put in some new blinds, because whoever lived here before, they like destroyed one of the sides on one of the blinds in the room that I use for my office. And I had like my Darth Vader out already and like some games and all that sort of stuff and a little display with some figures in it. And when I was at work when he did this, but when he came by to do the other blinds, I was home. And then he was saying, like, do you like going to the expo and stuff, and telling me that, like, he's basically, like, a geek. Which is weird, kind of, for me. I don't like people that I have a responsibility to be, like, to talking to me about things I like. I don't know. I know it's a weird problem to have, but like about a month and a half ago, one of the guys that I work with, that I've worked with for like 10 years now, he's a little bit older, and like we've known each other for a while, he's soft-spoken. He came up to me out of nowhere and was like, I didn't know you podcasted, and my heart just like sank into like the pits of my ass. I just felt sick. Like, I don't want people at work to know this thing, this side, you know? I like to separate business and fun in life. Yeah. What did he say? No, he literally just came up to me and like shook my hand as he usually does. And then he whispered that to me because he does this creepy little whisper thing. And then he said, I didn't know you did a podcast or whatever. And then I said, yeah. Then he just like smiled and walked away. And it was the worst experience of my adult life. I need this hunter. Or this lurker. God, I'm calling them hunters now. Yeah. Get close. That'll do. Which one? I don't know which one. The thing is that, like, if you've been around for a bit or you just kind of know how things are in my life, I work with Nathan, so I'm almost wondering if Nathan told this motherfucker about it. Or maybe he just, like, decided to Google me one day. And Google with the way they do things. Like, they detect what area you live in and then bring up searches that are, like, relevant to things around you. I do work with Nathan, yeah. I wouldn't say I work with him. We work opposite shifts. He works the weekend, I work the, weekdays. Okay. So this is all the stuff we need here. Yeah, I think he probably Googled me. But yeah, no, that's just how he talks. He whispers. An example of this is that, like, every now and then, he'll come up to me, shake my hand, as standard, like I just told you. And then he'll, like, tell me a dirty joke. And then I'll do, like, my fake laugh. Because everybody knows when you're in a place that you work with other people, like in a professional setting, you have a fake laugh. And, yeah, but you also, like, are part of, like, John's community and you listen to TDP and stuff, so Google takes that into account. So we'll do, like, our fake laugh, and then he'll just, like, peace out. It's weird, man. He gives me a handshake every time. Not every time that, like, he wants to say something to me, but he doesn't say anything to me unless, like, I come to work, he'll shake my hand and then say something and then, like, go off, and then he'll say see you later when he leaves. The thing is he's not a bad guy. As much as some people that I work with will tell you he's the worst person since Hitler. For some reason. He is older. He's, I don't know how old he is. He's probably 50s, I would say now. He is, like, a kid. Maybe, I don't know, he has, like, 2 or 3 kids, actually. Why do you live in a very slowly developing horror movie? No doubt, man, no doubt. I have no idea. So with Claire's B game, unlike Leon, we don't need to go back down to the very bottom, so there's no chute for us to jump down there. I'm sure the chute is still there. Like, I'm pretty sure that's probably canon, however, we're not too keen on jumping down into holes like Leon is. Then this'll happen. This is where I'm gonna take a hit, by the way. So as you can tell, the B game is actually where, like, the horror comes into Resident Evil 2. Because the first time you play through this, Mr. X just kind of like harassing you randomly the whole time. Makes you feel pretty uneasy. Did we get this already? We did not. Alright then. So we're actually done with this stuff now. Let's go meet up in Psycho Police Chief Irons' little torture porn sex dungeon area. I'm a little disturbed I haven't found like any bowgun ammo. It's honestly bugging me a little bit. Where does my cat sleep? Usually, when we're home, he will either sleep on the couch or he'll sleep on our bed. When I'm in this room, if I leave it open, because right now the door is closed, he'll just sleep on the floor in the corner. I can't remember how tough this thing is. Open your door for catapults.
Claire!
Sherry, you're okay.
I'm glad to see you're safe, Claire.
Cat on bed means no sex. True. Mail to the chief, to Brian Irons, chief of the Raccoon City Police Department. We have lost the mansion lab facility due to the actions of the renegade operative Albert Wesker. Fortunately, his interference will have no lasting effects on our continued virus research. Our only present concern is the presence of the remaining STARS members, Redfield, Valentine, Burton, Chambers, and Vickers. And if it comes to light that the STARS have any evidence as to the activities of our research, dispose of them in such a manner that would appear to be purely accidental. Continue to monitor the progress and make certain their knowledge does not go public. Annette will continue to be your contact throughout this affair. William Birkin. To Mr. Brian Irons, Chief of Raccoon City Police Department. I've deposited the amount of $10,000 to the account for your services this term as per our agreement. The development of the G-Virus schedule to replace the T-Virus is near completion. Once completed, I am certain I will be appointed to be a member of the executive board for Umbrella Inc. It is imperative that we proceed with extreme caution. Redfield and the remaining STARS members are still attempting to uncover information on the project. Continue to monitor their activities and block all attempts to investigate the underground research facilities. We're not reading any more of this. Fuck William Birkin.
Claire!
I'm going down there. Stay here and wait for me, okay?
Accidents like being bitten by a giant snake. Yeah, you know. Accidents. I mean, that's an accident, right? Maybe you shouldn't have been playing around my giant snake. Take that in whatever context you wish.
So you've made it this far. Not bad, girl. But I'm not letting anyone leave my town. Everyone's gonna die.
Calm down, Chief. What happened?
Shut up! You couldn't possibly understand what's happened. Those monsters from Umbrella have destroyed my beautiful town. How could they do that to me after everything I've done for them?
So it's true. You have been working with Umbrella. Then you must know about the G-Virus. What is it? Tell me!
If you must know, it's the agent that can turn humans into the ultimate bioweapons. Superior to the T-Virus in every way. Dr. William Birkin is the genius behind the project.
William Birkin?
I'm sure you've already seen his little girl running around here somewhere. Sherry, isn't it? In case you haven't already figured it out, the monster that's been tearing my precinct apart is yet another product of the G-Virus. An ultimate bioweapon. Umbrella must be trying to cover its tracks. But if I have to go, I'm going to take you with me.
He is an asshole.
What the?
That's so good, though. Oh, yeah. Little gross laboratory here. Staged on it, I know, right? It's so dumb. So good. Look at all this gross shit here. Kinda cool, though. It's so much more satisfying than the A scenario where he just basically is like Ben and gets ripped open. Also, it's kind of cool to see Birkin before he's in the form that you see him in as Leon, as he's still, like, in his transformation. I think it's cool anyway. I'm gonna be honest with you, I don't know how many shots he takes. He's done. I should have guessed when the music was over, but instead I just wasted ammo. Might be. You plan on playing all the Resident Evil games this October? Yes. But only the main ones. Not, well... I'm not gonna say not the other ones, because I actually want to play those more than the main games, but... Yes. Oh god, I gotta go back and get Sherry. Of course we gotta get Sherry. Why wouldn't we have to get Sherry? We always have to bring Sherry along. Escort missions and all that stuff. Gotta have the little kid. Why not? Why is that guy evolving? The virus is causing it. I might skip over Resident Evil 5. I'm not 100% sure on that. It depends if I can find somebody who wants to play Resident Evil 5, I suppose. honestly, Resident Evil 4 is what I'm worried about. That's the one I've beaten the least. Other people just become zombies. Other people didn't get directly injected with the G-virus. They got it through, like, a bubonic plague type thing and through bites. They didn't get, like, a full dosage.
Claire, you came back!
I can't believe the man who developed the G-virus is actually her father.
Claire, did you say something?
What's
nope.
Wrong, Claire?
Let's go.
It's nothing. But I think I found a way out of here. We should be able to find someplace safe if we can just make it out of town.
But...
Don't worry, I'll...
I really don't know how I'm gonna do Resident Evil 4. But you have to I'm actually sure a little worried about it. I might just skip it. What's going on? I wasn't paying attention. Resident Evil 6 is on the slate, because I've never beat it. I've only played Leon's story mostly through. Oh my god, Sherry. You are the worst. Come on. Dusk Till Dawn is such a good one. God, I love it. Alright, come on, Sherry. Ignore the corpse of your father. It would be kind of funny. He was just laying there dead. Operation Raccoon City, we're not gonna do. I'm not gonna do. Mainly because of the multiplayer focus and the lack of people actually playing it, it's kind of impossible to.
Come on, let's get out of here.
I mean, yeah, I don't disagree. It was a fun game. They just fucked up. I love that part. Every goddamn time. I need the lighter with her. I'm gonna bring it just in case. The fuck is this game and its cutscenes? No doubt, right? Honestly, I don't even know why they bothered making that door locked. That you need a lockpick for. Like, just come on. Oh, I don't need the lighter down here. Are there enemies down here, though? There are. Glad I brought the handgun down now. Other one? No? Okay. Standard grenade rounds. Really nothing over here. That's kind of silly. something just great. Come on, you have to give me more than just that. Especially if you're gonna put an enemy down here to fuck with me. Oh, there's a door. Okay. Okay, okay. Right then. No. Junkie, I always love the ridiculous shit you fill chat up with. It's always a good time. There's spooky games you want to play for October. There's a basic list of the stuff I'm willing to say I want to play on my Facebook page. Speaking of which, I'm in my dashboard, I'm not looking at my main channel. Is there a link to my Facebook page? My main channel? Because if not, that's something I should probably fix at some point. Get my socials. Leon!
What happened? You're bleeding.
I ran into this woman who is in trouble. Her name's Ada. Right after that, someone tried to kill me. Nearly succeeded, too. Ada went after the sniper, but I'm worried about her.
The sniper?
You gotta find her before something happens.
But you've been shot.
I'll be okay. It's Ada I'm worried about.
The sniper. The reason I use Facebook Junkie is because you can write more in there than on Twitter. I do want to see what's over here for her. I mean, yeah, I know that's there, but what about flame rounds? Okay, sure. Quit long OP though. Yeah, but if somebody's gonna be clicking a link anyway. Spider's hassling me. Trying to poop on me. Oh my god, I forgot the stupid thing. Oh, I'm an idiot. Christ, is it like my first day on the job playing this game? Good god.
Are you all right? What happened?
Get away from me. You just want my husband's G-sample, don't you? But no one will take that away from me. No one.
Husband? Then you must be Annette.
Huh? How did you?
We don't have time for that. Sherry is lost somewhere in the sewer system. I have to find her.
What? I told her to go to the police building. Why is she here? Now Sherry and the G-sample are both in danger.
What did she mean by that? Does Sherry have the G-sample?
All right, go get the valve, because I'm a moron, and forget simple things sometimes. You know what, while we're here. Might as well use that while we're here. Run past these spiders. They stop hassling me. Can I go up Leon's way? I can. Interesting. That's interesting. You know, I've never actually tried that. Which makes me wonder, what's in here? So this is a way that Leon takes back. In case that wasn't clear in the first part. Now here you need the lighter. Grenade rounds. Women always fainting and trying to protecting their husband's G-sample, am I right? I don't know, I'm gay. That's the best response ever. On the plus side, we're gonna pick these. Oh, there's three of them. Do I need the lighter for anything? No, I do for one more part. I think I'm gonna keep it. Because I'm interested. Look how, like, I have no bowgun bolts at all. That's insane, dude. Freaking crazy. I don't like the flame rounds are kind of okay later, though. Okay. We need that before I forget again. I was gonna put that away. We're probably fine doing that. Things will probably be okay. I want to see if there's something here for us. There is not. Okay. Back down we go. The infinite rocket launcher. Yeah. That was from Leon A. Why don't we use that? Because it screws up your score at the end of the game. Let me put it this way, if we get to a point where, like, I'm out of ammo or something, with Leon A, we got to a point where I ran out of ammo and I was in caution and had, like, one healing thing and one boss was just kind of being a prick, so I had to go back and get a bunch of ammo. If that happens again in this run, now that we have the infinite rocket launcher, I mean, I'm not going back to find ammo legit. I'm taking out that rocket launcher and I'm killing that boss in one shot to finish it. That's all I have to say about that. Net is unconscious. Yeah. The fuck were those giant spider things? Oh, you know, giant spiders. Pretty much exactly what you called them. I do believe I need this up. So, up it goes. That shit is scarier than the fucking zombies. I don't really find spiders that scary, so I don't agree. However, I find it gross when certain spiders, when you blow them up or whatever, they explode into like a bunch of tiny spiders in this game. I don't like swarms of things. We'll hold on to the lighter for now, even though it's probably a bad idea, but whatever. We get to do this shit again, I think? Yeah. Or maybe not. I don't remember. Okay. It's open. Weird. They get hit by the T-virus, or a giant spider is just a norm in this city. I mean, they're mutated. Pitch, make a really scary horror movie, then make that same movie, but the protagonist just pulls out a rocket launcher and starts blowing the shit out of everything. I mean, then you're just making a Michael Bay movie, right? I gotta be honest with you, I don't remember where we meet up with Mr. X again down here. I'd be lying if I said it didn't worry me a little bit. I still find it weird that you use a valve. Actually, it's less weird that you use a valve to turn that off than it is that you use a valve to move the bridge up and down. Make the porno version where they literally blow everything. But then Junkie wouldn't watch it. Because it has girls in it. Whoops. Zombies again? Yep, I think so anyway. Yep, there it is. That's what we were looking for. Can't remember if I need to actually find Sherry. Or if she'll just pop up somewhere. I think I need to find her. We'll be able to tell in a second. Maybe not. Interesting. He also has a military and his hate of humanity. I mean, you're not wrong. Definitely not wrong. Where the fuck do we find Sherry again? So the idea is that Leon already took the tram, which is why it's not here. So we have to call it back. Oh, there we go. Perfect timing.
Sherry, you're okay. Sherry, did your mom give you something called G-virus? Either a vial or a test tube?
G-virus? I've never heard of anything like that before.
Are you absolutely sure? If you give it to me, I'll hold on to it for safekeeping.
But I really don't have anything. It's the truth.
But why would her mom say something like that?
But why would her mom say something like that? Indeed. Oh God, Sherry, come on, man. Lift those legs, soldier. Let's go. Come on. So the reason I brought the lighter was because I want to see what this lights up. I think the key is still here. Only I think it has a bunch of flame rounds in it now instead of the upgrade for the Magnum. Really, she's never heard of it. G-Virus is literally all her mom talks about. You're not wrong. The annoying thing about Sherry is that she's useless, whereas in this part, Ada will at least shoot zombies with you. Okay. This is a sticky wicket we've gotten ourselves into. Okay, there's a zombie there. You dead. You are dead. What do you have now that there isn't? Okay, I guess nothing. You're just useless then. Useless zombie. To be honest with you, I'm not against using every last piece of ammo I have for the handgun to just kill zombies and look around a little bit. I can't see around that corner, thank you. Gotta get the quick fire down. I should have practiced it more there. I only started practicing it at the end, but you couldn't tell because I didn't hit it. It's really too bad. I do need to practice it more though. Need to get that down. Super invaluable. If you can do it. Every time you want to do it anyway. Oh my God, Sherry. Okay, Sherry. How close are we until the end? I would say about an hour and a half. The problem is that, like, legit, if I remembered where to go, we'd be half an hour away. But, like I was saying the last stream yesterday, that I don't remember Claire's B scenario, like, at all. Which is why it's taking me so long to get through it. So I'm gonna guess about an hour and a half. Like, we're pretty close. In all honesty.
Sherry, wait here. I'm going to check it out by myself.
Okay, I'll wait here, but hurry back.
basically, to put it in perspective for you, we are about to go to the laboratory. The laboratory's the last place, like the last location in this game. As a standard for Resident Evil games. It's got a message, hold on. Oh, it's a Facebook message. Never mind. I don't remember what's good here, so we're gonna take these two ammo types. I hate that shit, dude. That stuff actually scares me. Looking through a monitor and seeing, like, something coming towards you. That's one of the things I'm talking about when I say that that shit scares me. But, like, you can hear him. And now I know he's there. But I don't know where. Oh, good. Fucking security cameras. Bane of my existence. Yeah, that's Mr. X.
Okay, Sherry.
He's a tyrant. I think this is where we're gonna take a small break, by the way. Even though it sounds like junkies, like, raring to get to bed or something. Yeah, we're gonna take a small break. It's been about, what, an hour and a half? Yeah. Why am I trying?